and Bob Plunkett was way up high, guiding hunters on the Continental Divide, and I had a few things happen that I thought I should put into a song. We got up there about the 10th of September, some things had happened, and I always remember about how a routine pack trip went absolutely wrong. I guess the trip didn't start out that bad, because Manoon had already drank all the whiskey that we had, and I couldn't foresee any problems that happened to us next. I grabbed the mule cinch and I cut her in two, because I'd always heard that you're supposed to do, but I'd never done it if I'd known what was going to happen next. The mule kicked at me and I thought it was dead. She fell over backwards upon at her head, and I got out of the way before she hit the ground. I stood back and thought, I don't give a shit, and I watched this old mule continue with her fit, and it was then that I realized tonight I might not be going to town. Whiskey, bullets, and pocket knives, lack of showers, but plenty of lies, a phenomenon known as a hunting camp. I've bought a lot of horses, and you know that I'll sell some, but I've never seen nothing like the one from Bud Nelson's, the baddest mule ever known to man. The mule got up, and her eyes were red. She'd acquired a set of hobbles and some bumps on her head, and a blindfold he put on there just to make her mad. The elk's cut up, ready to load, and the mule's good and pissed, ready to explode. And Bob says, hang on, Kail, you ain't never seen a wreck like we're gonna have. We grabbed a hind quarter, we headed for the mule. Little did we know we were gonna go to school and everything there's know about a mule gone to hell. We got the meat just about chest level high, and that's when the hooves and the hair started flying. That mule stuck a number two shoe through the rib of that elk. Whiskey, bullets, and pocket knives, lack of showers, but plenty of lies, a phenomenon known as a hunting camp. I've bought a lot of horses, and you know that I'll sell some, but I've never seen nothing like the one from Bud Nelson's, the baddest mule ever known to man. I looked at Bob, he looked at me, and it was real damned obvious that we both agreed this old mule had definitely lost her mind. So we grabbed the pieces, what was left of her elk, not really feeling very proud of ourselves, we attempted to load this mule just one more time. Make a long story short, we got the mule packed, and that's about the time that the halter rope snapped and the hobbles also decided to break. She was jumping and a-kicking and a-raising hell, and Bob had had enough, and I could tell, so mule made just one too many mistakes. Bob grabbed his rifle and he jacked the shell in, and he pulled down on the mule, and with an evil grin, put 180 grains of powder behind some lead. Whiskey, bullets, and pocket knives, a lack of showers, but plenty of lies, a phenomenon known as a hunting camp. I bought a lot of horses, and you know that I'll sell some, but I've never seen nothing like the one from Bud Nelson's, the baddest mule ever known to man. I guess it ain't quite the best shot I ever saw, because Bob loaded the mule's front left leg off, and as you watched him aim again at the mule that he just bought. He looked down the barrel and he pulled a bead, and the old gray mule just picked up speed. You know, he never did get that second shot. So if you're ever hunting on the Continental Divide and south of Yellowstone on the Pacific Creek side, and you see a three-legged mule with half an elk, grab your rifle if you can get a shot. Me and Bob would be happy to pay a lot if you can verify termination of the mule from hell.